Get ready to match the stars. Edward Asner, Brett Summers, Gary Berghoff, Marcia Ron, Richard Dawson, and Betty White as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now, here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Rivers.
No.
Chris, thank you very much.
Oh, I'm glad. She says I have very nice suits.
Boy, would I love to play tic-tac-toe on you.
No, you can't do that. I want to point out that Charles Nelson Reilly is not with us.
Who?
And we do miss him. I mean, we love Gary and all that.
But who isn't here?
Charles.
You mean that's not Charles?
That's not Charles.
Who is it?
That's Gary Berghoff of MASH.
That's not
good. Well, now, wait a minute. Now, if you
somebody
don't believe...
give this man a pair of glasses.
I'm sorry. I thought Charles was not here, but everything's okay. Charles is here. So let's press on and say hello to our two players, Susie Parker and Earl Leonard here. How are you? Your husband here? Where is he? Down there somewhere?
The bearded devil.
Oh, I see. Okay. Now, Susie Parker has won $5,600, and she's going to be challenged here by Earl Leonard. We found out a little bit about him last time we were together. He's been married 47 years. He must be at least 51 to be married that long. He retired from the fire department. He's got children and grandchildren, and he's got a marvelous smile, doesn't he? He's a happy fellow. Well, we're going to start this game right after we start this message of interest for you. Here we go. I push a button here, reveal our first round questions, and ask Earl Leonard to make his choice. A or B, Earl?
I'll have to take A for my wife's name, Alice.
Alice. A for Alice. Okay, here we go. Now listen carefully, one and all. Contrary to popular belief, Eve was not made out of Adam's rib.
Good gravy, right. Marie.
She was made out of Adam's blank.
Ryan. Out of Adam's rib.
Okay. Did you hear that, Earl? Are you thinking about it?
Not too good.
You think about it a little more. Don't think about it too hard, folks.
No.
Just a simple little game. That's
is
all.
Is there a definitive right. answer, honey?
This was a big money.
Is there a definitive answer, sweetheart?
Yes, there is. Sure. All right, everybody's ready. Cut. Earl Leonard. Contrary to popular belief, now listen carefully and think about this. Eve was not made out of Adam's rib. She was made out of Adam's...
Arm.
It's all right. You got a pension from the fire department, right? Okay. He said he does have a pension from the fire department, so he's okay. What do you say, Edward?
Well, I mean, we must realize that was a long time ago, a couple hundred years ago.
At least, right.
And language changes a lot.
Right.
And in those days, for instance, wah-wah meant rib.
Oh, it did.
DD meant head.
Oh.
And apple meant something else. So I said,
there's the answer. She was not made out of Adam's rib. She's made out of Adam's apple.
I just thought of that.
You got it? Did everybody understand that? A little play on words there. You get it now, Earl?
I got it now.
Okay. Too late, Earl. Brett.
Well, you know I have a son called Adam.
Right.
Whose arm I'd like to break about four times a week. But I didn't say I feel terrible. I didn't realize that. I said shin bone.
Okay.
I don't know why I said shin bone.
Two losers.
The shin bone's connected to the fig leaf.
She was made out of Adam's fig leaf.
She was Greek. They like leaves in their soup. I don't know what it...
Gary Berghoff.
I don't know.
I say you don't.
I got Adam's apple just after you said it, though.
Right.
Almost the same time.
Getting closer.
Right.
Not made out of Adam's ribs. You made out of Adam's apple.
Is that the answer?
arm is what he said.
Yes, well, I had Alice in mind, but I had apple also in mind.
You did have apple, yeah. Okay. And Richard... would have the definitive answer, I'd bet at least a nickel that he would have the
Appel.
Appel. Yeah. See, I would have won a nickel if somebody had bet me that.
A nickel.
Yes, a nickel. Thank you. What do you say?
No arm, no shin bone. I had fig leaf another week.
So now, Susie Parker has this for her first round question, and let's find out how it goes. Fred said, "I've had it with my wife." Oh, he was really fraught. He said, "She doesn't believe in sex after blank."
Now, what did he say? What was the first one, honey?
Fred was angry. He said, "I've had it with my wife. She doesn't believe in sex after blank."
Have I got a terrific answer?
Splendid.
For that.
She doesn't believe in sex after.
I love my answer.
All right.
Would you give that to Susie?
Oh, that's the card that won her the $5,000.
They stole my other one. I had to make out a new one.
I'll walk over here now. By that time, Gary should have finished writing his answer. Right, Gary?
Mm.
That's your Susie's little souvenir of your win. She has $5,600 altogether. Put it in the slot quickly. And here we go. Fred said, "I've had it with my wife. She doesn't believe in sex after."
Oh, I have a whole galimafree of answers in my head.
A whole galimafree of answers?
I learned that from you.
You did?
Yeah, it's a very educational show.
Thank you. Did you look it up?
No, I just took your word.
All right. She doesn't believe in sex after...
Marriage.
After marriage. Hear that, Ed?
Yeah,
Kid gave a pretty good answer.
She's lived a lot in that little while.
Well,
as to me.
Yeah.
Yes, well, I know Fred quite well.
Oh, you do?
Yes, yes, and I know what he married. So I would say that Fred has a just cause because Fred is never satisfied, and therefore he does not believe in sex after...
Sex.
Yes.
Okay. All right.
The AMP.
That's... One in a row, now Brett.
Just a dash of Scoey Mitchell in here.
That's it, too right.
I told you I was thrilled with my answer. It's my own story exactly, to say nothing of Betty White's. Sex after marriage.
There it is. Kid gave a pretty good answer there.
Never mind.
Your last one was terrific.
Yes, but wait, you should have heard what I just had in my head. Just add a little class. Mirage.
Mirage. Okay. So that's two for you, Susie. Fred said, "I've had it with my wife. She doesn't believe in sex after blank." She says married.
Oh, not only is my answer not right, it's not even funny.
Sex after dinner? It's not that I have a headache here. It's just that I got a full stomach. I've never heard that. What is...
Dated a girl who didn't believe in sex after birth, which is very, very discouraging.
Yes, indeed.
So I said matrimony.
Matrimony with Susie. Now we come to our own authority, our very own local Joyce Brothers, who'll tell us about it now.
On the job training and all that. No, I resent what
went.
No, being married to Alan Ludden, a lot of things went through my mind. I thought of after breakfast, after hours, after the freshman year. I said after marriage.
Okay. So that's four. There's the end of round one. 4-0 is the score in favor of our current champ. Earl, you're going to have to get going after this commercial. Will you do that?
Try to.
Okay. Come right back and see if Earl gets going. Did you see? Hello. Round two, final round. Earl, it's your choice entirely, A or B.
I'll have to stick with the A.
A for his wife, Alice. Now, since no one was matched, or Earl, you didn't match anyone, everybody will play this round. Everyone listen carefully now. At the big people's banquet, Tiny Tom Thumb climbed up under the table and blanked into the soup. There's a small hotel. Who wrote that?
Paul Rogers and Hart.
Right. All right, the bottom tier is ready.
Well, we're just getting right there.
The slow ones in the class, we put them in the back row. Okay. Now, we come over here to Earl Leonard. Put up a slot there, Gary. At the Big People's Banquet, you've heard us do these Tiny Tom Thumb questions, haven't you? At the Big People's Banquet, Tiny Tom Thumb climbed up under the table and blanked into the soup.
Dived into it.
He dived into the soup. Okay. He said he dove into the soup or jumped into the soup.
Yeah.
What'd you say?
Well, I knew something that our guests didn't, that Tiny Tom was a gourmet chef.
Uh-huh.
So he had earlier tasted the soup and realized it needed something, so he got up under the table and...
He sprinkled into the soup. Okay. Just a touch of parsley.
Yes.
Sprinkle a touch of parsley into the soup. Okay. What do you say?
I said he rang his little bell and tinkled.
I see. Okay, Gary.
I said he broke his transmission into the soup. Like Mr. Asner's car yesterday. Is it dived or dove? I said dove.
He dove into the soup. There's one. One for you, Earl. At the Big People's Banquet, Tiny Tom Thumb jumped up, climbed up to the table and blanked into the soup, and Earl said, dived.
Now, if what you said earlier still holds, you would give this an okay.
Jumped or dove? Oh, yes, indeed.
Yes, yeah. That down.
Oh, sure. The same thing.
I think so, too.
Yeah, I agree with you. Do you agree with her?
Ask not for whom the bell tolls. It tinkles for you.
Okay. Thank you, Ernest Hemingway. Susie wins again. Dive, okay. Come on down, Susie. Congratulations once again. You stand by over here, if you would, please, while we talk to Earl. Earl, it was a real pleasure meeting a fine-looking gentleman like you, sir.
Thank you, Dean. It's been a pleasure.
We've got some gifts for you, together with our thanks.
Thank you very much.
Let's say goodbye to Earl Leonard.
Thanks a lot.
Come on. Now, here we go again. Are you ready?
Oh, yes.
Well, let's get right to it. Susie, we polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Paul Blank. Now, remember, the answer that audience gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it. If you match that middle one, the second most frequently given answer, you get $250, and the bottom $100. Now, whom do you call on for some help here?
Richard.
What do you say, Rich?
Paul Newman.
Paul Newman. Marvelous person and actor.
Rick?
Paul Revere! Bicentennial.
Marcia.
Paul Third. Paul Bunyan.
Paul Bunyan.
The corny answer.
I think you got three pretty good ones there. Paul Bunyan, Paul Revere, Paul Newman. Now, you have to make a choice.
Oh, it's between my loves and my bicentennial patriotism. Oh, let's see. Paul Newman.
Paul Newman. Okay. That's the one she's looking for. We'll find out if it's up there, and if so, where. Shall we begin at the bottom? And shall we reveal the $100 response? Revere. Revere.
There were no
patriots
near that.
Bicentennial,
you know.
It's bicentennial, that's right. They would have said that. Okay. One if I land, and two if I say, and three if I blow the whistle.
Come, sir.
Okay, let's hide, honey. Oh, I'm only kidding.
Just kidding.
All right, we are looking for Paul Newman. May we see the $250 number? Bunyan. Well, that's a 2 out of 3 so far. That's a good omen, right?
I think God's on my side.
All right. Here is the $500 response. Newman. Very well done. Good. Now you're going to play for another $5,000, aren't you? Because you play for 10 times 500 or 5,000. Remember to collect that. Who told you to ding? Don't ding unless I tell you to ding. Now, you've got to...
Give a little, take a little.
Right. You have to play with one celebrity, match him head-to-head exactly in order to collect another $5,000. Gosh, that would put you over $10,000.
Yes.
Which one?
Richard.
Richard, okay. All right, you stand and face me if you would, please, ma'am.
Can I hang on?
Yes, you may hang on. I'll get the $5,000 number, and there it is. It says, lamp blank. Lamp blank. Okay, he's finished. Now, Susie, there it is, lamp blank. You see it. What answer would you come up with to match Richard?
Lampshade.
Lampshade. Lampshade on a scale of 1 to 10 gets about a 4 from this group here, but they could be wrong. Now we call on Richard. She says lampshade will match you for another $5,000. Give her $11,200.
I said post.
Lamppost. Now, lamppost is very good. Lampshade, it's pretty good now that I think of it. Lamplighter is another good one. Yeah, lamplighter.
Lamplighter? Lamp?
Yes, Lego lamp. No, Betty, you got the wrong idea. It's a good thing you didn't call on her. Susie, you're up to $6,200, and you're still a champion. You're going to meet another player, but right now we're going to do a little business. Here it is, America.
Today's consolation prizes are Hanford Forge Stainless from Washington Forge. Complete service for 12, carefree stainless in a walnut chest, beautiful Hanford Stainless. And the calculator and Jolly Time Popcorn. It always pops tasty, tender, and crispy kernels. The whole family loves Jolly Time Popcorn. And a radio and finger-licking good Kentucky Fried Chicken and all the fixings. A real meal that's real goodness and only from Kentucky Fried Chicken. Well, rub-a-dub-dub, three men in a blank. One of whom was Gene Rayburn, and he'll be back in a minute when Match Game 76 continues.
Ready... Hello there.
You didn't introduce me.
I didn't introduce you. Let's welcome Terry Donath. Hey! Where are you from, Terry?
Well, I'm originally from Memphis, Tennessee, and currently I'm touring the coast.
You're touring the coast?
Oh, yeah. I live all over the place.
You do?
Half Moon Bay. Have you heard of it?
Yeah.
Poway.
Right.
And currently in Northridge, going to Cal State University of Northridge.
Right.
And I'm married, and I have a lovely wife named Sharon.
Oh, yeah, you must say lovely.
That's right, lovely.
Right.
I get it when I get
it. All wives are lovely, Terry.
That's right.
Right.
And that's about all.
That's it, huh?
That's it.
Okay. You ready?
Ready.
Good luck to Terry. Shall we begin? How do you feel?
Fine.
Good. A or B, Terry, it's all up to you.
B.
B it is. Here we go, new game, folks. Francisco the Monk.
Yeah.
He really keeps his vow of silence. Francisco doesn't make a sound, even when he blanks.
Honey, I'm sorry. I know. Could you do
Francisco
one?
The Monk.
Just because I love the sound of your voice.
He really keeps his vow of silence. Francisco doesn't make a sound, even when he blanks.
He's a tricky little devil. Never gives you anything you can use.
You know, Terry is touring Los Angeles, he said?
Terry is touring California.
For $2, I can take him to where Ed Asner's transmission is buried.
You two guys are chit-chatting.
I'm ready.
Oh, you're ready. Oh, I see.
I think
you didn't push it in all the way, and your light did not go on.
Oh, I didn't know there was a light there.
There's a light. When you push the card in, the light goes on, and that tells me you were all finished. They didn't tell you? Yeah, you're on. Yes. As soon as you walked in, I said, boy, Marsha's on.
How am I doing?
Okay. You're on, too. All right, Terry. Francisco the Monk really keeps his vow of silence. Francisco doesn't make a sound even when he blanks.
Goes to the restroom.
All right. Okay.
And he takes a rest.
Right.
Why, was there one missing?
I don't know. Yes. All right, Ed. Show and tell.
Do I have to?
Yes.
Francisco the Monk doesn't make a sound. No sound at all, even when he hisses.
When he hisses. Okay. Ed. Now, wait a minute. I just want
another line to the Christians.
Listen. You do have a fairly long-term contract on the Mary Tyler Moore Show. I mean, you wouldn't depend on anything like this for a living or anything like that.
And there's no danger of my being replaced.
Right. You tell him, Ed. What do you say, Brett?
What do I say?
Yes.
At the risk of repeating myself in a frantic attempt to succeed, I said Tinkles, which I believe is a match.
Okay, there's one. Gary?
I went in a completely different... I said that he never even makes a sound when he talks.
Good. I think that's a logical response to that answer. Marcia, what do you say?
Well, I didn't say any of those things.
I said belches.
A very quiet belches.
Francisco doesn't make a sound.
I'd say hisses
even.
Looks good.
Yes, that's, I agree. Okay,
Richard. No sound when he snores.
When he snores. Out of sound. All right, logical.
Nor Betty? When he laughs at all those other bad answers.
Yeah. So that's one for you, Terry, and your first round question will come along later. Right now, this is coming your way. How much time to say goodbye? 10 seconds to say goodbye? All we got is 10 seconds. How can you say goodbye? You can't say goodbye. So we will not say goodbye because you can't do it in 10 seconds. Do you understand what I am saying?
Wait, it's a whole 10 seconds.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 76. A Mark Goodson, Bill Trotman production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of these CBS stations.